Hi, this is Chelsea from Ref and Write. In this video, we will look at some clever techniques to present the study limitations in your research paper without reducing the impact of your work. If you still haven't subscribed to this channel, please click the subscribe button below. You must talk about the limitations of your work in the discussion section of the paper. One of the important qualities that the scientific community expects from a researcher is honesty and admitting when they have made a mistake. The important trick you have to learn while presenting your limitations is to present them in a constructive way rather than being too negative about them. You must try to use positive language even when you are talking about major limitations of your work. Let's look at some examples. In this example, the authors are trying to tell the readers that one of the drawbacks of their study is the small sample size. In the first example, the authors start the sentence with the word, unfortunately. This is a negative word. Don't use strong negative words like unfortunately, disappointing, etc. Try to use slightly less negative words like limitations, pitfalls, drawbacks, etc. In the second example, the authors have used the word limitation, which is a slightly less negative word. In the first example, the authors have not given any further explanation as to why the sample size is small, whereas in the second example, the authors have clearly explained the reason. They are saying that the sample size is small because the cases were limited to one hospital. They are also finishing the passage with a positive note, saying that even though it is a small study, it has yielded useful results, and future work should try to replicate these findings in larger studies. You can imagine the type of impact both examples might have on the readers. The first example undermines the credibility of the research, whereas the second example sets a slightly different tone and sounds a bit positive. Here is a slightly different way of presenting the same limitations. The authors have used some clever tactics here to make the limitations sound more positive. You can see that the author has used the adverb although at the start of the sentence, so this immediately tells the readers that something negative is about to follow. They are saying that although the study has yielded very important results, the sample size is a bit small. There is something else they are doing here that is quite clever. They are saying that this is because of financial constraints, and most studies of this nature suffer from this limitation. The authors are distancing themselves from the data and taking a neutral stance by saying that they are not the only ones experiencing this problem, and this is a well-known problem in the field. After reading this passage, you get a feeling that although the study has some limitations, it may not be the author's fault. This is a very good example demonstrating how to strike a constructive and positive tone when talking about limitations. If you have any questions, please drop a message below. We will answer it as soon as possible. If you still haven't installed Ref and Write software, please do it. It comes with referencing tools, plagiarism checkers, proofreading tools, paraphrasing tools, an academic phrase bank, and many other useful features to help you write your research papers and thesis. You can sign up for free using the link below in the description. If you are interested in training courses on research and academic writing, please visit our Learning Academy on Udemy. You can find the link in the description below. Finally, please subscribe to our channel to get future updates. Bye for now!